Well, I am Steve Savant, your host for the Quest for Financial Freedom, brought to you by Brokers Alliance. Need financial guidance? Call Brokers Alliance. I want to welcome everyone listening on the Family Values Radio and over the World Wide Web on YouTube, Ustream, Vimeo, and our social networks, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, the Insurance Forum. And, of course, you can contact me on my email address, thequest@brokersalliance.com, or call me toll-free, 1-800-290-7226. It's not what I know, it's who I know, and that's why my special guest on the Quest is Ken Davis from Bell & Associates, the Vice President of Advanced Markets and Certified Public Accountant, Certified Financial Planner, Charter Life Underwriter, Charter Financial, I think I'm screwing it all up here.
Yeah, Charter Financial Consultant.
There you go. I mean, all these alphabet. I feel like I'm repeating the alphabet soup here. Highly credentialed. And, of course, Ken was my co-host with us when we did for the great Good Hands people sponsored us.
Yes.
Allstate. And that's just a shameless plug. So.
Those are good days.
Those are good days.
And it's good to be back with you, Steve.
Well, right now we're trying to do – well, listen, we got to get money for our clients everywhere we can. And right now we're using tax advantage products with the kind of guarantees in contracts that are able to bring not only some peace of mind, but to reduce our bill to the government. I know they need it, but I don't want to give it. You know, if I can legally do it, I want to do it. In fact, by the way, before we get into today's delay, we're going to talk a little bit about delaying some retirement issues and so forth like that. But we talked about this Monday, and I just happened to be looking at the total, it's the U.S. national debt clock, and you can go out on the web. This is, take a few aspirins with you because you're going to need it. Because when you look at these numbers of our debt and what it is today, it's just blowing my mind. And I'm looking right now, I'm looking at the savings rate. And of course, we're going to talk a little bit about this today. The savings rate per family. Now, I'm just assuming they mean husband and wife here. Per family, the savings rate is $7,680. Ken, that's it.
Yeah, and that's not going to go very far in today's economy, is it?
No. In fact, actually, I'm looking at talk about our numbers aren't going to go very far for ours. I mean, I don't know who's going to pay this because right now I'm looking at total state, this is every state in the union, their revenue and their state debt is even money now.
Wow.
All states included.
I thought they were, most of them are in deficit. So
well, they are, but the ones that have a little money are included in this here.
Yeah.
So, I mean, we're in real trouble. But when I think about the Social Security, what we were talking about in yesterday's show, and the government is on the hook today, at today's present numbers, remember, I'm not talking about the future, $14 trillion in Social Security liability. That's what we're on the hook for.
It's huge.
The drug liability, prescription drug, is at $19 more than Social Security.
Yeah.
And on top of that, the Medicare liability for the greatest, or the, I should say the largest generation of all time, is at 76 T with a trillion dollar liability.
Gosh, it's just mind-numbing, isn't it?
Well, that's why we have to talk about this issue, Ken, about delaying the effects of early retirement and delaying some of this. Talk a little bit about, does it make that much difference to do this? I mean, we'll talk a little bit about Social Security delay, but does it make that much difference to delay a little bit?
Well, there's a couple answers to that. A lot of us focus on Social Security and what do I get if I start at 62 or 63, whatever you're allowed to do. And if I delay it to, I think for our generation, it's somewhere around 66 now. And what impact does it have on Social Security income? Another part of it, a little more subtle point, was I had a client come to me years ago, and he walked in and said, "Hey, Ken, I just retired, and I need to start taking some money off my portfolio." And I said to him, I said, "Well, look, you know, this is the amount of money you have, and I'm sorry, but this just isn't going to last based on your life expectancy." Mm-hmm. So he says, "Well, what can I do?" And I said, "Well, you can delay using the income off your portfolio." I said, "You told me that you could work part-time as a consultant for your prior employer." "Yeah." He said, "Yeah, I can do that." "And that your wife was working in a gift shop somewhere." "And yes, I can do that." I said, "Is that enough to live on?" He says, "Yeah." I said, "Well, gosh, look what happens if I just delay your retirement from 65 to 70. You get to accumulate that much more money for the retirement. Mm-hmm. You get to let it grow that much longer.
Right.
And then you have five fewer years to live off of it." Well, gosh, the double positive whammy of delaying mm-hmm. distributions was huge, and we saved his retirement. He was happy. He enjoyed being, you know, continuing to work mm-hmm. on a part-time basis, taking the summers off. It was a great solution for him.
Well, Ken, you and I just happen to be in this little tranche age group here where normal retirement age for us is age 66. Now, that's ours.
Sure.
If we were willing to just wait 4 years, the government will pay us 132% of what we would have gotten at age 66. That's just 4 years delay.
Yeah, and, you know, in getting all those credentials I've gotten, I remember one of the more difficult courses I took was on, and they talked a lot about that issue. And it has to do with things like life expectancy. How long do you expect to receive it? You know, if you have a short life expectancy, you've had some health issues or something, and you don't expect to last much more mm-hmm. than 75. Delaying it to 70, you have 5 years. If you take it now, you get more. The other question, and this is a philosophical, maybe a political question, is do you really believe that that money's going to be there?
Well, it's the full faith of the United States government. What, are you trying to question that?
Well, sure, but think about it. If you're in Congress and they keep delaying all of these issues and they don't address them, and it gets mm-hmm. worse and worse and worse, and someday it gets so bad that they have no place to hide, mm-hmm. they finally have to step up
that
and solve.
That day may have come.
Well, and it just gets worse from here. Mm-hmm. But at some point in time, the Congress says, gee, we just don't have enough money, and sorry, guys, we mm-hmm. promised this to you, but I'm sorry, we've got to push it out or reduce benefits or do something like that. They're hard choices, but we have no choice. Think about it. Social Security, when it was first put in place, the income was not taxable.
Right.
Today it is taxable. It may not be taxable at higher levels. It might 50% of it's
well,
taxable.
Well, Ken, what blows my mind is that I know that if I work and if I make so much income, I'll have to pay Social Security. But now you're telling me, I mean, in a couple of shows earlier this week, you said, oh, it's not just that. It's that if I might have some municipal bond, or not municipal bond income, but some other things, like you were saying, the capital gain, I think you were talking about, that could affect my Social Security, something I never thought. I thought all I had to worry about was earned income out of wages.
No, unfortunately, not too many years ago, Congress put into place, looking for additional revenue. They said, well, gosh, look at all these wealthy people, and that seems to be their favorite target. And quite frankly, some of them aren't so wealthy they're targeting. Let's tax some of the Social Security. If they're below a certain level, we'll let them have a free ride. Mm-hmm. At a certain level, then it goes 50% of Social Security is taxable.
Does the tax go back into the Social Security fund, or do the taxes go to the regular general fund?
Well, that is an income tax concept.
Yeah.
That is not a tax on wages. That's a 1040. You file your return, and that becomes part of the general revenue.
Unbelievable.
So, and then, Steve, don't forget, we said 50%, but it can go as high as 85%. And in fact, you might have part at 50, part at 85, and if you make enough money, all of your Social Security income is included in your taxable income at 85%.
So you told me there's power in delaying. I believed you. Now you're telling me, but it may not be there if I wait.
Well, you have to ask yourself the question, is it going to be there? Can you depend on it? How long are you going to live? It's kind of the old adage of a bird in the hand is worth two in the bush. Gosh, you could die tomorrow. Mm-hmm. And you might have delayed for 5 years, and in the month after you start taking distributions, you pass away, and then it's gone.
Well,
greatly diminished to your spouse if you have a spouse.
Yeah, if I'm married, it's like half the number.
Well, yeah, the rules get really kind of complex. You can look at her base, mm-hmm. at your base, and whether you're married and all that kind of stuff. It gets a little complex to discuss here.
I noticed that if you delay, and especially right now, remember, they have not drawn a line in the sand past what I'm about to say.
Right.
In 1960 or later, the new normal age is 67, right?
Right.
For everybody 16. And they haven't drawn another line.
You're talking about people born in 1960.
Right, 1960. But even if they waited till 70, right, three years, remember, we would get 132 at our 70 because
right.
we're in a different different age group.
Sure.
That drops to 124, and it's been dropping every age group.
Exactly.
So I thought delay would help. I want to help the United States government by taking constructive receipt of my Social Security, not when I'm due, age 66 in my case, yours. I'll wait till 70 to get 132% of my original number. But maybe now that's not even going to happen, because now we're wondering, how are they going to fund all this?
Well, and let's get back to a fundamental issue. The way for this country to survive and to do well is to grow. We need to grow our economy. We need to help people make more money so they can save more money for retirement. And the bigger the economic pie gets, the more taxes come in. And one of my favorite presidents, Ronald Reagan, that's exactly what he did, is he brought a message of hope and growth and prosperity, reduced taxes, reduced regulation, and the result was a large growth in the economy. And we had similar kinds of problems back then. We had debt problems, the Vietnam War, high tax rates. We had a lot of that going on, and we pulled ourselves out of it. And I think that's the message of hope for the American people.
Well, I think if we are willing to go after this, it's not just cuts. We're just going to have to be effective and efficient in running the government.
That's right.
I mean, we are so – I can't imagine how much filler is in that budget. And I think the American people are going to come to the place where you know, I mean, not that you want to farm this out to personal corporations and private corporations, but you're going to see some of this go that way.
Well, look at what's happening currently. One of the state governments is – the governor stood up and said – hey, we can't do this anymore. We can't afford all this stuff, and I'm sorry, but we have to cut back salaries and benefits for our workers in the state government. They've got people demonstrating in the streets, and I don't care which side of the argument you're on, and it gets very political, but the fact is, those are the hard choices we'll face in the future.
Well, I think future is now. It seems like we're just going to have to face this up. Listen, it's almost 2012. Maybe the Mayans saw something that we didn't see. I don't know. Listen, in the next segment, we're going to continue with the last part on Social Security. You're listening to The Quest for Financial Freedom. I'm Steve Savant. We'll be right back after the break.
Century, the lost decade, where most Americans experienced a level of unprecedented financial loss. But some savers and investors found one sector of products that actually made them money. Products that were guaranteed, tax advantaged, and backed by some of the biggest names in the business. Now, focus on the returns on your money without worrying about the return of your money. For over 30 years, Brokers Alliance has maintained one of the largest inventories of guaranteed and tax-advantaged products in the country and serves a nationwide network of financial professionals.